want to remove annoying objects like this light switch, this red box, this cable, or your eggs from immersive 3D 180 footage?
Hey, how dare you remove me?
Alright, maybe not kimchi, but if you're a VR 180 filmmaker, matte painting and rotoscoping in 3D aren't just useful, they are essential. And let's be real, this stuff can get tricky. Welcome to this masterclass, 3D object removal in VR 180. This is your deep dive masterclass, covering the best workflow across three different VFX software: Mystica Boutique, which is free for educational purpose, DaVinci Resolve Fusion, and Boris Effect Silhouette, and Mocha with AI. Whether you are a filmmaker saving your VFX budget, or pro VFX artist breaking into immersive 180, or just someone like me making a 17th century narrative immersive film in 16K 90 frames per second, but unfortunately, time travel hasn't been invented yet, so I have to erase all the modern day stuff, this tutorial is for you. And beyond just making your shots look clean, this essential skill can turn your passion into a $1,000 day rate job in the world of immersive filmmaking. So grab a cup of coffee, clean your timeline, and let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh and Kimchi, back with another pro-level immersive editing masterclass. Today, we're diving into Mystica Boutique, a Hollywood-level compositing tool. Think Nuke or DaVinci Resolve Fusion, but with built-in 360, 180, and VR workflow. Now, why Mystica Boutique? Two big reasons. First, it comes with Mystica VR, which is one of the best stitching software out there. If you are working with multi-camera VR footage and don't want to pay for Canon for EOS VR utility, this is a game-changer tool that you need. Second, it's free, at least for educational use, which means most of you watching can get started right now without paying a dime. Now, quick disclaimer, if you are using this professionally, meaning you are getting paid, then yeah, you need to get the full version. But here's the good news. The only differences between the free educational version and the pro version is the render codecs, not even resolution. That means you can still output full 8K Canon R5C footage or the 16K 90 frames per second Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive content for YouTube VR or MetaQuest, no problem. The only catch, educational user can't explore EXR sequence or ProRes higher than LT, which honestly is totally fine for most VR creators. But if you're working on Netflix, Apple TV, or a paid client project, you will need at least ProRes 422, which means it's time to upgrade. Good news, Kimchi got your bag with a discount code for Mystica Boutique full version. So if you're making money with this, using the code and support the good people from Spain making this tech possible. For the rest of you, go download Mystica Boutique educational version from the SGO website and get ready for the next step, stitching your footage like a pro. Before we open Mystica Boutique, we need to set up our project correctly. First, open Mystica Config 2. This is where we define our project setting before launching the main software. For Canon R5C or R5 Mark II VR 180, the standard factory preset 8192 by 1496 is good enough. But since I like to push think, I create my own preset called Apple Vision Pro, where I set the master format dimension to 15360 by 760/80, 16K, and set the main frame rate to 90 frames per second. When that's set, hit OK, and now start Mystica Boutique. Now, the interface might look a little bit different if you are coming from other software, but don't worry. If this is your first time using Mystica Boutique, watch my first tutorial right here to get comfortable with the interface and the basic, then come back here. Now, let's create a new project. Click project, then create a new project. It will ask you to import some footage. Now, go to my Patreon and download some sample Canon VR 180 footage, or you can use your own raw fisheye. Drop them directly on the timeline, click link as clip to bring it into the project. Now, hold down Alt to duplicate that clip and place it directly under the original. Then, select both clip and hit align left to make sure they are perfectly synced. If you are using Canon EOS VR or Red V Raptor, both the left and right eye image are stored in a single file, but to do proper stereo work, we need to crop and separate them, which is why we duplicate the clip right here. Now, with both clips selected, go to Effects and add VR Stitch. This is where the entire Mystica VR software is built inside Mystica Boutique. Double-click the effect, and you will go into the VR stitching interface. Now, under Render option, we need to tell Mystica that we are working with a dual lens setup. Click Add a Camera, one for each lens. If you are using something like an Insta360 Titan, you will click this multiple times to match the number of lenses, like 8. Next, click Low Preset and select either the default Canon RF Dual Shine Lens template or my custom preset, which you can download for free on my Patreon. To check your stereo alignment, turn on 3D and pick black and white anagraph. This gives you a real-time depth preview. Now, one of the benefits of using Mystica Boutique is that it is designed natively for Meta Quest for VR editing. If you have a Quest 3, you can actually see the live VR feature to push your stitch directly into the headset for real-time preview. I have a tutorial on that right here if you want to check it out, but for this tutorial, we are preparing for Apple Vision Pro, so that feature doesn't really matter here. Now, to fine-tune the stitch, click Show One Input and move the yellow circle until it fully covers the left fisheye, then do the same on the right eye. It doesn't have to be perfect, Mystica VR will handle the rest. Now, turn off Show One Input and click Auto Calibration. This is Mystica new AI power fisheye calibration tool. Select VR180, hit Calibrate, and boom! You now have a perfectly calibrated 3D VR 180 video. Click back to return to the editing timeline. Now click the yellow edit marker and set your in and out point for rendering. Click output, select Apple ProRes LT, and make sure the resolution is set to 8192 by 1496, which is the standard for Canon EOS VR. Hit foreground render, select preset edit marks, and that's it. Your footage is now stitched and ready to go. Now, what if you are not using Canon or RED? Maybe you are working with two GoPros, two Insta360 Ace Pro, or even a modded Coolcam 3 Ultra for VR180? Well, don't worry, I got you covered. Next, we will quickly walk you through dual fisheye workflow, so you can handle any camera pair. Alright, now pick my Apple Vision Pro preset in Mystica Config and open Mystica Boutique again. You see the resolution now is 16K at 90 frames per second. Now, the reason I set the project size to match my final output size is because rotoscoping and matte painting really depend on that. Even though Mystica official recommendation is to work in a lower resolution to save system resources, that doesn't really work for us. We need to make sure the project resolution is same as output final resolution. And for Apple Vision Pro, that means 16K at 90 frames per second. That is also why Apple Immersive Video looks so good, because it's freaking 16K, massive file size. Luckily, unlike Adobe products, Mystica Boutique can handle 16K no problem. That's why Hollywood loves it. Now, throw in the two raw fisheye video. If you double check inside, you can see that each fisheye is 7680 by 7680, full 8K resolution. I can't tell you which camera I shot this on, but if you have been following Apple news, you can probably guess. This is from our upcoming 30-minute narrative VR film shot in Paris. And if you want to see how this all comes together, check the final film right here. Now, the third big benefit of using Mystica Boutique is that you never need to render until the final delivery stage. For 16K ProRes 4444 footage, that saves you a ton of storage, which means you're also saving money. If you have ever done VR VFX work, you know that struggle. I'm sharing a lot of industry secret here, stuff that most studio gatekeep. But I really care about the professional immersive community, and I believe knowledge should be free. So if you appreciate that, subscribe, give Kimchi a thumb up, and drop him a thank you comment down below. All right, now let's stack the left and right eye like this. Click Align Left to sync them. If you're using a high-end camera system, you will already be perfectly Genlock sync, so you wouldn't need to do anything. But if your camera doesn't support Genlock, you need to sync them manually. Now, go to Effects, add VR Stitch, then double-click inside, add and other input camera, then click show one input and adjust the yellow circle so it fully covers the left fisheye and do the same for the right eye. Now lower preset. Mr. already has a built-in preset for most camera, or use mine, which you can grab for free. If there's no preset for your camera, just use auto calibrate like I showed you earlier and let AI figure that out for you. And that's it, you're done with stitching. Now it's time to get into the real magic, rotoscoping and 3D painting in immersive. Let's go! Before we start painting out unwanted objects in 3D, there is an optional but important step that will make your footage look way more professional. The proper VFX workflow go like this. Denoise first, then do your VFX work, and finally add noise and film grain back in to match the original footage. Mr. Boutique does have a built-in denoise plugin, but personally I like to use AI based too. Topaz Video AI is great, but my go-to is Boar's Effect Denoise ML, which is actually built inside Silhouette. And that's exactly what we will cover in episode 3, where I will show you how to rotoscope and paint in immersive 1D using Silhouette. To keep things simple for this tutorial though, I will use Neat Video Denoise. And here is a critical tip. The denoise stage should always happen before stitching, directly on the original raw fisheye footage. Understanding the paint job. Now, let's take a look at the footage and figure out our approach. Our film is set in 17th century France, and obviously there were no light switch back then, so we need to remove it. But there's a catch. If you flip between the left and right eye, you see they are slightly different. That means we have to handle them separately. And here is another thing. You can't just use a single frame to patch it like you would in Photoshop or Premiere. If you watch closely, our male talent moves through the scene and eventually casts a shadow over the light switch. So a single frame wouldn't work. We need to copy and blend the pattern across the entire duration of the clip. The good news is the talents never cross in front of the light switch, so we don't really need to do any rotoscoping in this example. That makes this a relatively easy paint job. Now that we have our strategies, let's get to work. Preparing the left and right eyes for painting. First, we need to separate the left and right eyes for independent painting. So let's duplicate the footage by holding Alt and drag a second copy into the timeline. Now let's group them to keep things organized. Open the attribute panel and we name the first clip shot 29 left eyes. Do the same for the second clip, but name it right eyes. Now select only the left eye, go to effects and apply switch eye. Switch eye is a stereo 3D effect in Mystica that let you choose which eye to work on. Open switch eye and set it to left only. Then go to the right eye clip, apply switch eye and set it to right only. Now go back to the left eye and add vector paint. This is found under effects image. Double click and open vector paint, go to frame 0 and let's start painting. Using vector paint to remove the light switch. Once inside vector paint, click and go inside show paint interface. Under paint, select the tool Chrome Force. This is the most important tool you will need. It allows you to copy pattern from one patch, one part of the frame to cover unwanted objects. And because it's a vector base, it adapts to the changing in lighting and shadow condition. Now choose a brush size, hold down Alt and click an area of the frame that have the texture you want to copy, release Alt and start painting out the light switch. Now to blend things more naturally, reduce the opacity of the brush, pick a different area like below the light switch and soften the edges like so. That way, there's no harsh cut between the chrome texture and the surrounding environment. Okay, we are now painting out the one frame, but if you move to the next frame, you'll see that the paint is gone because it's only applied to one single frame. To apply this across the entire clip, click all shapes, then select all frames. Now, if you go back and scrub through the timeline, you'll see the light switch is completely gone across the entire sequence. What's amazing about vector paint is that it automatically adapts to the shadow and light change, make it look completely seamless. Applying the paint job to the right eyes. Now we need to repeat the process on the right eye, but we are not going to repaint it manually. That's a big no-no in stereo 3D works. Instead, go back to the timeline, select only the vector paint effects from the left eye, and hit Ctrl plus C to copy it and select the right eye layers and hit Ctrl V to paste it on top. Here's the key thing. Because stereo vision works with parallax disparity, the paint job wouldn't light up perfectly. So all we need to do is to adjust the disparity to make sure the paint adapts correctly to the right eye. Double click inside vector paint on the right eye and make sure you are also on frame 0, just like we were in the left eye. If you are not, set the reference frame to match the left eye exactly. Now enable show paint interface and don't replaint anything. Instead, use the select tool and you will see the old paint job right here from the left eye. Click transform so we can move everything together. Now select all the paint strobes and shift them horizontally until they perfectly cover the light switch. Make sure you only move them left or right, not up or down, to avoid creating vertical disparity, which can break the stereo effects. Once it's aligned, hit all shapes and all frames to apply the adjustment across the entire sequence. If your view doesn't refresh, click the obey button twice to force an update. Sometimes when working with large video file, the interface doesn't refresh immediately. It is a bug, Mr. Kelp will fix it soon. Now check the result. The light switch is gone on right eye. It looks great, but if you need to fine tune it, just select the strobes again, adjust it slightly, and repeat the all shapes, all frames, refresh process. Finalize the 3D stereo composite. Now go back to your timeline, move the right eye stack under the left eye and add a stereo 3D node on top to combine them. Open stereo 3D and now boom! The final 3D views looks perfect and the light switch is completely gone in 3D. Now just set the yellow edit marker, go to output and render this out as your final result. And that's it! Next we're going even deeper, rotoscoping and 3D painting in Immersive VR 180. Let's go! Alright, the next shot. Way more challenging, but there's nothing Kimchi, my Shiba Ninyu, can't figure it out. So let's break it down. First, we need to remove this wire. This part is easy and follow the exact same process you just learned. But there is a big red telephone box sitting right next to the chateau. And here's a problem. Both our talents crossing in front of it. That means we can't just paint it out. We actually need to rotoscope them out in 3D first before we can properly remove the red box. To show you how complicated this can be, here is a node tree in DaVinci Resolve Fusion, which we will cover that in episode 4. Now don't worry, Mr. Boutique makes this process a lot easier, but it's still not as straightforward as example 1. And since I don't want to melt your brain all at once, we'll cover this more complex example in the next tutorial right here. But if you can't wait though, you can jump over to my Patreon and watch the full breakdown right now. Thank you for watching and learning this important immersive stereo workflow with me and of course Kimchi. My job isn't just to teach you the tool, it's to push you to become a better immersive creator, to think outside of the frame, to master skill that can turn your passion into career in immersive filmmaking. Because here's the truth, this industry is seriously lacking talent. If you are sick of watching the same recycled TikTok trend and you are ready to create something more impactful, more meaningful, and more long-lasting, something that actually challenges you and can't just be copied overnight in a copy and paste creative culture, then subscribe on this YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram. And let's change the future of storytelling together. See you in part 2 of this series.